Jive Hive Jeff from Two Hacks Garage. Well, the next part of this build with these cylinder heads is the valves and the seats. As we tore these heads down, Jimmy went ahead and checked out the valves on these, and he didn't quite like the way the valves were actually going in and hitting the seats. Obviously, that's something you want for correct combustion, all that type of good stuff to make power. You do not want these leaking. Like I said, these were a budget head, so we're going over every detail on these. So what am I talking about on where it's touching on the valve seats? Well, let me show you here. So in here, like I showed you in a previous video, you have the actual valve seat itself right along this edge right in here. And that's where this valve comes into play and actually starts making the seal through here. So why are we doing this? Well, as if you can see on here, look at that valve and look at these marks through here. Hitting the seat, not hitting the seat, hitting the seat, hitting the seat, not hitting the seat, and so on. All these valves were like that. I'm not going to go through and show you every single valve, but as you can see, they weren't exactly sealing on there. And why that's important is when you come in here and put these in, as you can see, turn that a little bit, you want that to seal as these are going up and down, up and down, up and down. And what's going on here on that seat itself right through here, and then where the actual seat is, we get a better picture of that here, right in through here, it's not actually sealing all the way. So what that's going to cause is it's going to cause leak. It's going to cause, you know, less combustion pressure, less everything with this. And when you're kind of building a street strip or high performance motor, you want these valves to seal properly. So when it does ignite off, it's got that cylinder pressure, it's burning off. And when everything's opening and closing, it's doing it correctly. So what we're going to do here is we are actually going to, first step of this is we're going to grind these valves down. He's got a really cool valve grinding machine, and that's what we're going to do. So he's going to go through and re-grind these valves to make sure they actually hit the seat. Now, I'm going to later on is get all this cleaned up. So after I clean that up, Jimmy's going to go through and he's going to re-grind the seat on these. So that way, when we put this in and it's going back and forth, it's got a proper seal. See you soon. So if you look here in this video, you can see on that valve, on that seat, look how it's going back and forth. What Jimmy's going in there is he's taking it on this stone slowly but surely, and he's cleaning that up so it's actually true. Instead of going 45 degrees, it's actually going to go 44 and a half. That way when it's going in out of the valve seam or valve seat, it's actually sitting there slamming back and forth and making a good tight seal. So that's what we're doing. This is what you get when you buy some budget-oriented heads, but this is also what you get when you check everything when you get it. These are going to be good sealing valves, so it's back to work. here's something really cool with this machine. So obviously on that side, as you guys see, that it grinds valves. Well, this also does the valve stems. So basically you would put your valve stem in here, tighten everything down, and you surface the valve stem. So this comes into really big into play if you don't have adjustable rocker arms. So with this, what you do is once you would get everything measured and get your height set on it, you would go in and micrometer it, and you would actually just surface the actual valve stem. Just kind of wanted to give you guys a little quick thing on that. So yeah, so that machine there would surface your valve stem to set your height on valve stems. Like I said, this comes into play when you have non-adjustable rocker arms, shaft mount, like, you know, Chryslers have. So yeah, this is actually a really valuable tool, and I'm learning a lot about it. Now it's time to get back to work. All right, well, as you can see in the video, we stopped grinding on valves, and there's a reason being for that. This is where experience comes into play, and this is where Jimmy is showing me something here. He found that even though these are brand new valves, they're actually bent. Let me show you what I'm talking about here. Watch the dial indicator move. This valve is approximately 10 to 15 thousandths out. That's not good. Long story short, it's an absolute junk valve. So what I had to do just now is call Speedmaster, let them know what's going on, and they're gonna send me a set of valves. Where this plays into is time. My time and everyone else's time with this is very valuable, and the goal was to get these heads wrapped up by tomorrow. That's not going to happen now, but you know what? Lemonades, lemons, that whole thing. We're going to get it right. I'm just glad that we caught this. The exhaust valve seemed to be fine, so all I needed to do was get a set of intake valves. I didn't get one. I got a full set of eight because as we were going through the rest of these, we saw about three or more of these that were also out. So with that, we're going to get back to work on some other things and see you soon. Real quick, just to show you on the actual valve stem. So I'm gonna recalibrate this back to zero. I did set this up and tested it, but as you can see, our dial gauge is actually set up on the actual stem. Watch this. That valve stem is brand new and it's bent. So we checked, like I said, we checked the exhaust side on these and they're fine. But the intake valves themselves are actually bent. Now, why that's important is these things are gonna go in and out of that valve guide, and what you don't want to happen is these things hitting that valve guide, getting them wore out prematurely and all that. Then you're gonna have sloppy valve movement and everything's just gonna be geometrically an absolute mess. So we're gonna do the right thing, ordered up the new valves, regrind them, check them, and put them back in so we can get these heads done. So for us, it's back to work. Lemons into lemonade moment again. A little bit of a time delay, but we'll get there. See you soon. All right, so that is how you go in and you grind the valves down to properly seat within the valve seats. As you can see, we did run into a little bit of an issue there. The actual exhaust valves, they were fine, they were true. We got those ground down, those are done. However, as you saw on the intake side, we actually had brand new valves that were actually bent. We put them on the lathe, we checked them all out with the dial gauge, and as you can see, they were 10, 15 thousandths off. We don't want to put those in there and have them not seat correctly. Even with grinding them true, it's still not gonna work because you can't grind them true when that happens. So those valve stems would get in there and they'd also mess up the valve guides, cause all kinds of issues. So, you know, as I went into this, I knew these were a set of budget-built heads. I did a head review video on them, a couple of them. Make sure my mic's working. It's been one of those days. But as you can see, there are some flaws in these. One, the flaws being is, as being a good casting, they did have junk valve springs, so we're replacing those with a set of Howards. Stainless valves, great. Initially, they looked good. But as you start getting a little bit deeper into them, you could see that they don't actually seat properly with the valves into the valve seats, so we're grinding those out. Now, as we ground them out even further, we come to find out that the actual intake valves on these here, they weren't true. So when we put that in there, we noticed it was, you know, wobbling a little bit, tried grinding one. It's not gonna actually grind right. One of the biggest things with that is, just, you know, my opinion, I'm not an expert, but they're just Chinesium. So you kind of get what you pay for when it comes to these parts here. So I did call Speedmaster, they're gonna send another set. But that being said, I'm gonna take the wise words of Jimmy and I'm gonna price out a much better set of valves just in case. The reason being on that is I do want good valves. I don't want these to come back in, and we have 16 valves and only two that are actually usable. So this is gonna be a lemons into lemonades moment because I did learn a valuable lesson on this, but we're gonna get there. We still got a lot more work to do. We were hoping to kind of finish up some of these heads tomorrow, but you know, I'm not gonna get these parts until next week. So once we get them in, we'll be busting ass and moving forward with that. So with that, I will see you tomorrow.